Technical drawings describe mechanical components, their geometry, their dimensions and positions, and the associated dimensional tolerances. They use a standardized graphical language that allows a subcontractor to understand the intent of the designer. The drawing is even sometimes contractually binding between the parties, and serves as a reference in case of dispute on conformity of the produced parts. Amongst position and size indications, and dimensional tolerances, one can also find surface texture specifications, marked with a root symbol. The root symbol is defined in the ISO 13002 standard, whose latest version is from 2002. In general, this symbol is not used alone. It contains, at least, the name of a parameter and the associated tolerance limit. Here, for example, the RA parameter has an upper limit of 0.7 micrometers. Other indications are possible, and must be placed at particular locations, as we will see later in this presentation. In addition, several default indications are implicitly defined, and do not need to be noted on the drawing. They are important though, and need to be understood. Please note that, in this presentation, we chose to follow the ISO convention that uses the comma, as decimal separator. Surface texture indications have evolved over time, as have their interpretations. One can still find drawings with old indications, that are now obsolete, and that sometimes contradict modern indications and interpretations. Unfortunately, obsolete notations, or even incorrect ones, are sometimes still taught in schools and universities. Some are still included in trendy books used by students. This first obsolete notation, frequently seen on drawings, is from 1992 or before. In this former version of the standard, the tolerance was placed on the left of the root symbol. This example referred to the RA parameter, which was implicit, and a value of 1.2 micrometers. This next indication used a roughness class, here class number 6, which corresponded to an upper limit of 0.8 micrometers. Example 3, explicitly mentioned another parameter, here R, Y, with a limit of 8 micrometers. Example 4, specified a bilateral tolerance for the RA parameter, with a lower limit of 1.6 micrometers and an upper limit of 3.2 micrometers. Example 5, specified, on the left, RA with a limit of 1.2 micrometers, and under the root symbol, another tolerance for RZ with a limit of 7.5 micrometers. All these indications are now obsolete. They should not be used anymore on drawings. These indications, linked to old versions of standards, refer to old parameter definitions, either from ISO 4287 of 1984, also obsolete, or from ISO 468 of 1982, cancelled since. Again, these notations should not be used anymore on modern drawings. The only correct place to indicate a parameter is now under the root symbol. The minimum required indications are the parameter name and the tolerance limit. Many other indications are defined by default, and can be omitted. When other values are to be used, that are not the default ones, they need to be explicitly written. For example, here, the filter bandwidth defines a cutoff of 8 micrometers for the lambda S filter, and a cutoff of 2.5 millimeters for the lambda C filter. It is also possible to define two parameters under the root symbol. The two tolerances have to apply at the same time, on the same surface. Indications have to be written at specific places, under and around the root symbol, as described in ISO 13002. The only mandatory indication is the parameter and its limit. An indication about removal of material during machining can be placed just above the triangle, on the left. The direction of texture lay can be indicated on the right of the triangle. A specification may apply on all surfaces around the workpiece. In this case, a symbol is placed on the corner between the horizontal bar and the oblique line. And additional information about machining or materials can be indicated above the horizontal bar. Now, we will study in detail how to write all these indications. The specification string, below the root symbol, contains several terms. Some of them are implicit, and can be omitted, when they correspond to the default value. The first term, is the type of tolerance. Is the limit an upper or lower limit? If this term is omitted, it means that the limit is an upper limit, symbol U. The second term defines the filter type. Usually, the Gaussian filter is used for most roughness parameters. Several letters are defined for the different filter types. The third term is the most important, as it defines the filter bandwidth, with the micro roughness cutoff, lambda s, and the principal filter cutoff, lambda c, for roughness and waviness parameters. Then, after a separation slash, the parameter name is written. If all the terms before the slash are omitted, because they are equal to the defaults, then the slash is not written. In some cases, when the parameter needs to be calculated on a different evaluation length, it is specified as a multiple of the sampling length, here 8 times the lambda c cutoff of 0.25 mm. This is not a frequent practice, but it can be found on some drawings. Then, the decision rule for the interpretation of the limit is defined. By default, it is the 16% rule. We will study this rule in detail later. If the max rule is required, it has to be written explicitly, as on this example. Finally, the tolerance limit is written, without unit. The unit is deduced from the specified parameter. Beyond the specification string, below the root symbol, other indications can be noted. The triangle on the left can be open or closed, or contain a circle, depending on the constraint that is required for the machining, regarding removal of material. At the foot of the root symbol, on the right of the triangle, it is possible to indicate the direction of the texture lay. Some machining techniques leave a signature on the texture, with grooves that can be oriented differently. The most common are either parallel or perpendicular to the projection plane of the drawing. Other symbols are also possible, such as M for multidirectional, C for circular, R for radial, and P for particular. When the specification applies on all surfaces around an object, a small circle can be added at the corner between the horizontal and oblique bars. And additional indications can be written above the horizontal bar, about machining or material composition. The root symbol is usually placed, on a drawing, with the triangle in contact with the specified surface, horizontally or vertically. Or the symbol can be written on a leader line. On a face view, the leader line can point to an element. The root symbol can even be added on an existing dimension, when there is no risk of confusion. In the case of a complex drawing, or when there are many surface texture specifications, it is possible to use simplified symbols that are explained elsewhere on the drawing. Here, in this example, a general specification applies on all surfaces, with a tolerance of 160 micrometers on RZ. Without removal of material, except when marked with the simplified symbol, that corresponds to a tolerance of 16 micrometers on RZ, with removal of material. As explained earlier, many indications are defined by default, and are implicit. However, they should be understood clearly, especially when doing a verification. Here in this example, the specification contains two parameters, one with an upper limit, the other with a lower limit. But it is important to be aware of the associated default values that are not explicitly written. They are very important for the evaluation of parameters in the same conditions as the designer had in mind. Here, the cutoff of the main filter, 2.5 mm, is not the default cutoff value. It is therefore written in the specification. Be careful with the dash in front of the cutoff value. It is not a negative sign. It is just a separator from the micro roughness cutoff value that is omitted because it is the default value of 2.5 micrometers. The new standard, ISO 21920-1, which will soon replace ISO 13002, introduces a modified root symbol with a dash above the triangle to represent a specification on a profile. The top horizontal line that completes the root symbol is now mandatory, while it was optional in ISO 13002. A specification with the new dash means that the reference standard is ISO 21920-1 and not ISO 13002. Therefore, the associated parameters are defined in ISO 21920-2 and not in ISO 4287 or ISO 13565. This dash also allows users to distinguish surface texture specifications between profiles and surfaces, as ISO 25178-1 defines a different sign for aerial specifications. Another important difference introduced in the new standard is the position of the parameter and its limit in the specification string. It is now moved to the front of the string, just after the tolerance type, U or L. It clarifies the specification string, especially when the string is long. Now the parameter and its limit are in front of the line. The next important difference concerns the default decision rule. In ISO 13002, the default rule was the 16% rule. In the new standard, the default rule is now the max rule. It simplifies the interpretation of the limit and removes a rule that was never understood or applied correctly. Normally, users apply the 16% rule through the so-called simplified rule, which can be summarized with this series of tests, described in an annex of ISO 4288 and of ISO 21920-1. The problem with this rule is that, for the designer, the specified parameter shall be within the limits. But for the metrologist, up to 16% of the values can be out of limit. In particular, the one value above the limit can be strongly out of limit, leading to quality problems on the final product. In addition, the method sometimes requires a large number of measurements before a decision can be made, which can be expensive. This rule is also not compatible with capability procedures, nor with the decision rules described in ISO 14253. These are the reasons why it is not the default rule anymore. It can still be used, if needed, but then, it has to be clearly stated in the specification, with the T16% symbol. ISO 21920 introduces three symbols for decision rules. They can be written in the specification string, below the root symbol. T-max corresponds to the max rule. No measured values shall be outside the limit. It is now the default rule. T16% corresponds to the former 16% rule, and it has to be explicitly written when it is required. The new symbol T-med corresponds to a limit compared to the median of the measured values. Finally, some specifications are not defined by default anymore, such as the filter bandwidth. The new standard requires for the bandwidth to be clearly specified in an effort to clarify the specification and to educate users. There is, however, an exception for some common parameters, where the bandwidth and other indications can be deduced from the tolerance limit via a new concept called setting class. The explanation of setting classes and how they are calculated is outside the scope of this presentation. It may be the subject of a future video. In conclusion, we can say that indicating a clear surface texture specification on a drawing guarantees an efficient functional behavior for the workpiece. It requires the designer to follow the standardized formalism, and for the metrologist to understand how to read and interpret the specification. Profilometry standards are about to change, with ISO 21920, which should be published in 2021. Following its publication, the former standards will be cancelled. It is therefore important for users, industrial or subcontractors, but also for students and metrologists to be informed and trained to these new practices. We hope that this presentation contributed to this goal. Thank you for watching this video. Do not hesitate to comment below and mention your needs in terms of information and training for future videos. Click on like below the video and subscribe to the channel to be notified when a new video is published. Discover other resources on our Surface Metrology Guide, and visit www.digitalsurf.com, the home of the Mountains Map software. Thanks a lot.